Good morning, students. In the last turn, we discussed extraction of metals which are low in activity series. Today, we will continue with the extraction process of metals which are in the middle of the activity series. You all might be well aware of the various metals in the activity series. Zinc, iron, lead are the metals which are in the middle of the activity series. These are found as oxides, sulfides or carbonate ores. Metals are easier to extract from their oxide. This is achieved by reduction of the metal oxide. The sulfide ores and the carbonate ores are also first converted into oxides and reduced finally to extract the metal. In the last session, we used these terms roasting and calcination. So, what is roasting? Roasting is basically heating of an ore in presence of oxygen. The sulfide ore on heating in presence of oxygen, also known as roasting. It gives us the metal oxide. Here, you must remember for future purposes also that sulfide ores are always converted to metal oxide by roasting process. Let us take an example of a sulfide ore, ZnS, that is zinc sulfide, on heating in presence of oxygen or roasting gives zinc oxide as the main product. And sulfur dioxide gas is evolved. Now we have metal oxide, and to extract metal we will reduce it. This we will learn in the next slide. Before learning the reduction of metal oxide, let's discuss calcination also. As calcination also gives the metal oxide as the main product. The carbonate ores are converted to metal oxide by this process. Let's take an example of zinc carbonate, that is ZnCO3. When heated in absence of oxygen, it gives zinc oxide and carbon dioxide gas is evolved. Now both roasting and calcination has given metal oxide. Finally, to obtain metal from these metal oxides, they react with a reducing agent and metal is produced. Carbon is the most common reducing agent. So, when metal oxide reacts with this carbon, metal and carbon monoxide gas are formed. In our example, zinc oxide obtained from roasting of zinc sulfide and calcination of zinc carbonate is treated with carbon, which reduces it to zinc and carbon monoxide. Metal oxides can also be reduced by using displacement reaction. The highly reactive metals can displace the metals from their metal oxide of low reactivity. Highly reactive metals such as sodium, calcium and aluminium can be used as reducing agent in these cases. We have one example of displacement reaction here, manganese oxide, that is MnO2, as MnO2 is reacting with aluminium. Now, aluminium is highly reactive metal, whereas manganese has low reactivity. So, aluminium will displace manganese from MnO2 to give us manganese aluminium oxide, and high amount of heat is also released. As you all know that the reaction in which there is release of heat is called exothermic reaction. This reaction is highly exothermic, so the metals produced are in molten state. Thermite reaction. This reaction which we just learned comes in a category of reaction called thermite reaction. I will repeat what a thermite reaction is. Listen carefully as this is very important reaction. The reaction between metal oxides and aluminium is highly exothermic and the metals are obtained in molten state. Such reactions are called thermite reaction. There is a very important application of these reactions. Iron oxide when react with aluminium produces molten iron. This reaction is used to join rail tracks and broken machine parts. The reaction is as follows. Fe2O3 plus 2Al aluminium gives aluminium oxide, that is Al2O3, and iron and high amount of heat. As you can see the picture, thermite welding is being used to repair the crack on the railway tracks. So, if you remember the application of a particular reaction, it will be easier for you to remember reaction also and its definition also. So, we have completed two topics in the extraction of metals. First was extraction of metal of the low reactivity, and today we completed the extraction of metal of medium reactivity. Definition and application of calcination, roasting and thermite reaction was also completed. Most of the things, if you pay attention, you will remember for a long time. So give at least half an hour to the topic and try to find what kind of questions are asked in board exams from this part of the chapter. So this is it for the today. Thank you and have a nice day.